गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम डॉक्टर संगना बुर्ली, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर तात्यासाहेब कोरे, कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मसी, वारणानगर। टुडे आई एम डिलीवरिंग एंटी हाइपरटेंसिव ड्रग्स। मैं लर्निंग आउटकम्स आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो, students should able to remember the basic concept of hypertension and definition of hypertensive drugs. Students should able to classify the antihypertensive drugs, understood the mechanism of action of antihypertensive drugs. Students will able to enumerate the adverse effect of antihypertensive drugs. Students will be able to develop the communication skill to explain the drug therapy. Come to definition of hypertension. Hypertension is a disease characterized by persistently high arterial blood pressure. So blood pressure is a lateral pressure exerted on the vessel wall. So let us know what is the normal blood pressure. So it is systolic blood pressure divided diastolic pressure, 120 divided by 80 millimeter mercury. So if the patient suffering from hypertension, or we'll say the patient is hypertension, so the systolic blood pressure is more than 140 mercury millimeter and the diastolic blood pressure is more than 90 mercury millimeter. So let us go to the classification of hypertensive drugs. Here different types of classifications of hypertension. Among these are drugs are available for treatment of hypertension. First of ACE inhibitor, example captopril, diuretics, example thiazides, calcium channel blocker, verapamil, angiotensin second receptor antagonist, adrenergic receptor antagonist atenolol, vasodilator, hydralazine, renin inhibitors, elsikirin, aldosterone receptor antagonist spironolactone, alpha-2 adrenergic receptor agonist prodrusin. Among these classification, I will explain about one of them, ACE inhibitor. ACE inhibitor, example captopril, enalapril, ramipril and lisinopril. So these are dipeptides, sulfhydryl containing proline surrogate, ACE inhibitors, hypotensive agent. These are recommended when the preferred first line agents are contraindicated or ineffective. So, mechanism of action of inhibitors. Before understood the mechanism of action, we know the physiology of renin angiotensin system. It is responsible for increases the blood pressure by decreasing renal arterial pressure and by decreasing sodium in renal tubule. So automatically it stimulates the release of the renin. So renin is a protein synthesized extraglomerular cells of the kidney. It acts as a substrate, or it acts as an angiotensinogen present in blood to release angiotensin 1. This angiotensin 1 is converted into angiotensin 2 by ACE present in small vessels, mainly in the lungs. Once the angiotensin 2 have two effects by which it causes elevation of arterial pressure. That is vasoconstriction, and so it has a powerful vasoconstriction, therefore causes vasoconstriction of artery. Constriction of arteries increases the peripheral resistance and increases the blood pressure. Mild constriction of veins increases the cardiac output and increases the blood volume. So next come to that, angiotensinogen 2 also increases the salt and water retention by kidney. It indirectly stimulating the Jg cellular surface receptor by releasing the aldosterone production from the adrenal cortex. So aldosterone is a term act on a distal renal tubule to cause in kidney. Aldosterone is term act on distal renal tubule to cause increase the absorption of salt or sodium salt and water retention. So this is the normal physiology of renin angiotensin system. Increase the blood pressure. Drugs like ACE and ARBs, spironolactone and diuretics, but our drug ACE inhibitor like captopril enapril act by inhibiting the conversion of angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2. Once the angiotensin 2 decreases the secretion automatically, it decreases the output of sympathetic nervous system. It increases the vasodilation of vascular smooth muscle and decreases retention of sodium and water and increases the level of bradykinins. And other antihypertensive drugs are shown in these slides. We'll discuss in the next class. So this is the mechanism of ACE inhibitor. So next, reflection spot. What are the common adverse effects of ACE inhibitor? So why this is adverse effect of ACE inhibitor are important? Because these drugs are long-term dosage for hypertensive patient. So students must able to enumerate the adverse effect of ACE inhibitors. So in your notebook, write down adverse effect of ACE inhibitors. Some adverse effect of ACE inhibitors I will explain in next slide. So these are adverse effect of ACE inhibitors. Drugs, you know already, captopril, enapril, etc. Cough, hyperkalemia, hypertension, angioedema and dysuria are the adverse effect of ACE inhibitor. So cough, so 20% of the cases the persistent brassy cough produce of these ACE inhibitor drugs. Hypokalemia, in renal failure patient the hyperkalemia shows the adverse effect of this ACE inhibitors. Hypotension, first dose may occur fall in blood pressure. Angioedema means swelling of lips, swelling of mouth, swelling of nose. These are produce adverse effect of ACE inhibitors. And dysuria, loss or alteration of taste are the some adverse effect of ACE inhibitor. Contraindication of this ACE inhibitors in pregnancy due to teratogenic effect. So next, 50 is the therapeutic use and dose. Hypertension used in case most commonly, and these are also used in cardiac failure. These drugs are also used in myocardial infarction, diabetic neuropathy, progressive renal insufficient. So these are the therapeutic uses of ACE inhibitor drugs. Dose 25 to 50 mg BD or thrice a day, 1 hour before or 2 hour a meal. Thanking you.